Ryan Taylor Natural Remedies presents 6 Early Signs of Diabetic Foot. If you're a diabetic, it's very important to look out for problems in your feet. Diabetic foot is a term used loosely to describe health problems that occur in the feet, including nerve damage, problems with blood flow, and the changing of the foot shape. Unfortunately, some diabetics have lost a toe, a foot, or even a leg due to the vascular damage that occurs with this condition. In today's video, I'm going to share with you the top 6 signs of a diabetic foot to be aware of. This video is for educational purposes only, so do speak to your doctor if you have any medical concerns. The earliest sign of diabetic foot is tingling or a burning sensation. If you feel a tingling, burning, stabbing, or a shooting pain in the foot or the toes, then this means that you're suffering with neuropathy, a type of nerve damage. The high insulin and glucose levels in your blood is killing the nerve endings in your feet. This is one of the early stages of diabetic foot. The second sign is a loss of sensation. Shortly after experiencing the tingling sensations I just mentioned, the feet may start to become numb and you may lose sensation. This is a sign that the nerve damage is progressing due to the poor blood sugar control. Number 3 is athlete's foot. Although anyone can contract athlete's foot, diabetics are much more likely to have this and more frequently because high blood glucose feeds the foot fungus, causing itching, redness, and cracking of the skin, especially between the toes. Antifungal sprays can be used to cure this. The fourth sign is diabetic ulcers. If you develop a deep sore or a break in the skin that won't heal, this is indicative of severe problems in the feet due to diabetes. Foot ulcers can also occur from minor scrapes and cuts that won't heal properly because not enough blood is reaching the feet. Up to 10% of diabetics will get foot ulcers. Sign number 5 is gangrene. Foot ulcers that become progressively worse may develop gangrene, a serious condition where the loss of blood causes the tissue to die in your feet. This can lead to amputation and losing your toe or foot, so ensure that you speak to your doctor immediately if your sores produce a sour-smelling pus with redness and swelling. And finally, number 6, a change in shape. Although rare, nerve damage from diabetes can also lead to a change in the shape of your feet. This usually starts with redness, warmth, and swelling. Later, the bones in the feet begin to shift or break, causing the feet to have an odd shape known as rocket bottom, medically known as Charcot's foot. If you experience any of these symptoms and you have been diagnosed with diabetes, it's vital that you speak to your doctor to prepare a treatment plan for your particular case. Be sure to examine your feet regularly and check for any ingrowing toenails, changes in shape, color, swelling, blisters, corns, or warts, as these can cause more problems for diabetics. Wash your feet every day in warm, not hot, soapy water. Test to make sure that the water isn't too hot using a thermometer. 90 to 95 degrees Fahrenheit is safe. It's also important to keep the blood flowing to your feet. This will help to minimize the damage caused by high insulin and high blood sugars. To do this, you can put your feet up whilst you're sitting. Also, wiggle your toes for a few minutes throughout the day, moving your ankles up and down, in and out, to help the blood flow to your feet and legs. Regular exercise is essential, not only to improve the blood flow, but also to help your body eliminate the excess sugar in your blood by turning it into energy. Walking, stretching, swimming, or bike riding are all excellent ways to do this. If you want to learn more about overcoming diabetes, click on this video here. Thank you very much for watching. I wish you great health, wealth, and happiness.